Let's get this started. Counting down for our autonomous in 3, 2, 1, go! Immediately beginning our autonomous. Again, the higher scoring team aiming for those upper goals. Aiming to place those wobble goals in the right spot. However, it looks like there is a collision on the blue side. Remember, these robots are not controlled by the drivers. They are all controlled by automated programming, which means that if there's a collision during this field, the rest of the programming is going to be messed up, and you end up in a situation like we had here where we only have one of these wobble goals scored in the right spot. Red Alliance, however, has not had any such problems in this beginning section.
Driver, pick up your controllers. 3, 2, 1.
Entering the driver control period with a slight lead on the Red Alliance. If they can hold this lead, that means we are going to end this set of semifinals and move into the finals with the Red Alliance as our finalists. However, the Blue Alliance is going to try their best to make sure that doesn't happen with their superior shooting skills, hopefully, taking the lead and moving us to a third semifinal match. But it looks like we've got some strong defense being played on the right side of the field between 18253 and 9889. You'll notice that 18253 is trying to score in the middle part, their side, their middle goal on the right side here, because that allows them to play more defense. However, 8393 is shooting into that top goal as well from a different part. Some of these robots have to be aligned very specifically to land in these top goals, but other robots have more of a rotational top part of their bot that allows them to shoot from pretty much anywhere in the back half of the field. 18253 continuing to play very, very strong defense, pushing their robots around, making sure it's very difficult for the Red Alliance to actually get those scores, and it seems to be working because Blue Alliance is currently in a very, very, very slight lead, 135 to 122, with 1 minute left in the match. This defense is crucial right now, but if the defense goes too far and they start pinning these robots, they're going to end up getting penalties from the referee team, so they have to be very, very measured in how they play this defense. But again, it does seem to be working. Blue Alliance is holding that lead, 171 to 134. And also, there's a ring stuck in Brainstem, as you know. The robots can only carry 3 rings at a time, which means Brainstem having a ring stuck in their robot means they cannot hold as many rings. It is a tragedy for them. Now we have entered our endgame. You're going to see robots aiming for those batons there to knock them over and get those power shots, as well as the chance to pick up those batons and place them outside the field, just like 9889 is doing for extra points. 10 seconds left in the match. Can we get some power shots on here? We have 1 power shot, 2 power shots. 1 power shot from Red, 2 power shots from Red. And that's the end of the match. 245 to 220. Blue Alliance ekes out a win just barely, but maybe not. It's gonna come down to penalties and final calls from the refs. Anyone could win this game, and it is the difference between a third match in the semifinals or a move straight on to the finals.
Well, it looks like we could keep seeing 3 matches, which is great for us value-wise. We like that proposition value there. So semifinal to match number 2. You see, a semifinal 1 match is the next one coming up, but we're going to be talking about semifinal 2 match number 2. Talk to me a little bit. Who was competing in that match, Sean?
Yeah, so we had 8393, Brainstem Robotics, and then we also had 9889 Cruise Control for the Red Alliance. Gears of Fire, 516, sat out. They were the Alliance captain. We're seeing that becoming a pattern. The Alliance captain sitting out for a more heavy and more brute robot to play both matches. Then on the Blue Alliance, we had Team 18253, the Beach Bots, and Team 7303, Robo Avatars, playing together. Beach Bots didn't look like they were shooting much, but we can talk more about that in our replay.
Let's head into replay. We'll take a look at our autonomous mode.
Yeah, so in auto, we had a Blue Alliance collision. And when you go into autonomous, right, first of all, you just saw that. Beach Bots missed 3 rings. They hit right on the net, and then they're collided right here, right? That messed them both up. They scored almost nothing in autonomous, 48 points. Red Alliance is going to be way ahead in autonomous. Diving into teleop, the thing that we saw here was we had Robo Avatars shooting. They pretty much got free reign on this side of the field. Beachbots just kept on going back and forth with Brainstem and Cruise Control. They would go one hit. Right there, they got a hit on Cruise Control. Now when Brainstem comes back, they're gonna get a hit on Brainstem. And so here and there, they would shoot 3 mid golds, and then they would go back to hitting the 2 robots. Brainstem did a really good job with their turret. They're able to be hit and still hit the accurate shot, but still wasn't enough for them, in my opinion.
What is some of the parameters around defense in this game? You know, in the qualification rounds, if you're joining us then, not a lot of defense being played because it's all about total score, right?
Right.
But in playoffs here, you can play defense. So what are some things you can and can't do with defense?
Yeah, so with defense, let's say I hit a robot while it's shooting. That's perfectly legal as long as my intent is not to damage the robot. So be kind and careful with the other robots, but that's still legal. One of the things that you can't do is pin a robot against a wall. So we didn't see any of that happen. You can't pin a robot between two robots. One of the other things that you can't do is mess with people holding these wobble goals, right? In the end game, we talked about this in the last match, you have these wobble goals that you're trying to score across the field. If a team is trying to score these wobble goals, you can't play defense on them, and that's in the rule book.
I just want to say, for being called wobble goals, they seem to tip over a lot.
Yeah. So one of the things that I believe the refs are discussing right now is if you watch this instant replay, you see 83-93, they've got a ring stuck in their robot right here. According to the rules, you can only have three rings in your robot at once. And so by having that ring stuck, their drivers are right here. They couldn't see that ring. The refs had a hard time seeing that ring. So they're figuring out whether that ring was actually worth giving a penalty for,
sure,
and what the penalty may be.
And penalties are typically 10 points?
Right. So there's two types of penalties, a minor penalty, which is 10 points, and a major penalty, which is 30 points. And that's subtracted from your alliance's score.
So as we move in to the end game on here, once again, it's the final 30 seconds. If you're watching live, you kind of hear that whistle sound, essentially, right? As we go through, what strategies got implemented here during the end game?
Yeah, so in the end game, we saw these power shots come into play. I think we had a couple wobble goals, but as we get in, we have 20 seconds left, right? None of the power shots are knocked over, and now the teams are lining up for that. But beach bots, man, they played some hard defense against 83-93. Right there, you can see the ref pointing. They backed away, so the pin wasn't penalized, but they're really pushing Brainstem to stop them from getting it. I think they had two power shots apiece, and then Red Alliance decided to get one wobble goal. Blue Alliance got none.
So we're going to be moving in. The referees are still conferring right now. So as we do that, we're actually going to take a look. We got a couple of great supporters of this program. Let's learn a little bit more about Stryker and Holly have been supporting fun streams. Let's take a look.
This stream is made possible with support from Stryker Careers. Be part of the future of medical device technology. Join an incredible Fortune 500 company that will support you being a mentor or volunteer in FIRST. No matter what stage you are in your career, Stryker has something for you at careers.stryker.com.
Stryker and Stryker Careers, you want to learn more, once again, go check them out and see what they're hiring for. Lots of great careers, regardless if you're in FIRST Robotics or not. And there you have it, Blue Alliance tying it up.
Yep, exactly.
245, 228, Ishan.
Right, 10-point penalty making a bit of a difference there. That end game from Red tried to make it up, but Blue Alliance's Beachbot's defense, really, really solid. Let's take a look at what these teams do right behind us.
This stream is made possible with support from Stryker Careers. Be part of the future of medical device technology. Join an incredible Fortune 500 company that will support you being a mentor or volunteer in FIRST. No matter what stage you are in your career, Stryker has something for you at careers.stryker.com.